magical stuff out of
Wreck
the way.
Will lead the way forward along with Gek. Perception as we go. Okay.
Is it worth me to fix myself onto Battlecat?
Do what?
To fix myself onto Battlecat so that, no. Like... No?
Oh, okay. Did you see that earlier, Arthur? The dungeoneering?
Oh, right. We got completely sidetracked. Your dungeoneering check.
Yeah, 33.
The surrounding stone is igneous rock, meaning that magma or intense heat recently formed the tunnel. Gekido, as you step into the next room, you find heavily armored bodies that lie strewn across the cavern. Their black armor sundered. Brilliantly covered crystals jut out from among the corpses. You easily recognize the Hell Knight armor, and in fact, many of the Hell Knight armor, they're unique. You know, each one will have his own, like, little painted symbols. Many of them are among the most devout of Hell Knights who would follow Aster around while he was in town being chaotic.
I don't mean to suspect you, but do you know anything of these Hell Knights?
I kick them around inconspicuously.
They appear to be dead. Very dead.
Perception check to examine the bodies and see what killed them and if they took their stuff. Also, Aster, I might recommend a heal check.
Yeah, I have that.
I attempt to sniff the bodies and detect any scents on them, but then realize I cannot. Damn it.
Ah.
That was a D-tape, too.
Yeah. Yeah, no.
Okay, you look over the bodies. You're pretty sure they're dead. There's some unusual injuries on them, but you're unclear as to what formed them. Before you guys move around too much, let's make a couple more checks, because moving around quite a bit. I need a knowledge local check and a knowledge dungeoneering check.
Here's my local, here's my dungeoneering.
Dungeoneering.
Okay, knowledge local lets you know that the Hell Knight armor here is all distinctive to the Order of the Nail, and even more so that it is specifically from Fort Inevitable, where you guys base out of. Your dungeoneering check lets you know that the crystals here are not natural formations, but they are creatures known as Krizmals, and they can be quite hostile. As you do notice those Krizmal corpses, you see a Krizmal appear to the north of you, being chased by a small ball formed entirely of blades and eyes. What do you guys do?
Oh, what is this? I question everything.
I think I will attack the Krizmal, given that that seems to be what killed everyone.
But is it not being chased?
Yeah.
Gek.
I will move over to here to block the way with my tiny body.
I must warn you, if you come any further, your life may be a forfeit.
Yes, I say this in common. I don't know what this is. already an action
the
to attack one.
Small scorpion crystal creature doesn't seem to understand you.
Alright, already an action to attack one if I have ever if I am ever in one of their squares.
Okay. Master.
Alright, let's just 1 second, sorry. Yeah, I'm gonna have what's the answer move up. And attack the Crismal.
Okay.
Alright. Anything happen?
You hit. You're doing quite a lot of damage. And you can also, I'm guessing that's a grab.
Yeah, I guess with
you
it.
Initiate grapple with it.
Alright. And then I guess I'll move here, because it can't attack, because it's not its turn. And then I'll just, I guess I'll smack it around.
Assuming it doesn't have combat reflexes.
I am assuming.
Well, it's grappled.
That's a good point.
There are many reasons it couldn't do anything.
Alright, you smash it into pieces.
Oh.
Chop a star.
I tried to on it.
Here it is.
I am going to move up here and ready an action in case that thing, the ball attacks me.
Okay, what's next?
What does the. Can I. No, wait, I can't see it. I walk forward. Well, I wobble forward. Can I kind of see the ball through my allies?
I think you have line of sight.
Okay. I try to identify it.
Knowledge planes. Some form of outsider.
I could do that.
Chitin.
Oh, it's a chitin.
Called an auger. You can ask one question about it.
Alignment.
Lawful evil.
Huh. Can I assume that it made of been with the Hell Knights?
Maybe. The alignment indicates maybe.
Okay. Do you know about these Hell Knights over here as I shout out?
Are you doing anything else on your turn?
I'm just trying to communicate with it.
This is a floating mass of blades. It has no apparent mouth, correct?
That's correct.
Ah, okay, never mind. I try to communicate with it while realizing I can't talk to it. That's it for me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I see such a perfect line formation right now.
So, it begins, like, doing barrel rolls, and it flies up here, provoking arrows from all of you.
Where does it move to?
Except for me.
So it flies through Arubis, Answer, and Astro Squares.
It just flies through, it
doesn't do anything
any...
else. Would you like to take an AOO? Apparently you would.
Oh, man.
Both your AOOs hit.
Why do we always have to attack everything?
Why did you do
it
that?
It wasn't even attacking us, why?
It falls to the ground.
I kind of shrugged my shoulders.
Figures that the chaotic person would be the one doing it.
I tried to warn them not to approach us, but they didn't have a choice because Asta went up first, yes. Why does it always have to result?
Morningstar, Aster?
What?
Tell me about your Morningstar.
It's adamantine magic and shock damage.
Okay. So, as you guys move deeper into the room where this combat took place in, you find pale white and gray crystals all over the room in tightly packed formations, clustering in the corners and around the central pillar. You can make a knowledge planes check while you're in here.
Sweet.
So, I'm going to move forward, because I don't feel comfortable with having our squishy people in the front.
all the pillars here and all this white crystal matter is actually chrismal waste. It is fragile and worthless. It easily shatters.
Yeah. Okay.
As you're examining that, the little ball pops back into life and starts flying again.
Really?
Huh. Yeah, really.
I was just going to move answer there before.
It's okay. We'll certainly roll initiative again.
So,
it's immortal!
Aster, don't kill it again.
Back up sex!
Turn.
Everybody?
Oh, I don't want to say anything strange. Not in there. There you go. Oh, no? There.
Alright, thank you.
So, hold on. What do I perceive happening?
So, the creature just sort of, like, rises back up into the air.
I will choose to begin entering the first round of 10 of diplomacy. I'm sorry what my companions did. And then...
Okay. Aster.
Damn it, Aster!
You are going to thwart every diplomacy attempt here, aren't you?
Okay, you smack it down once again.
Damn it, Aster.
I poke it. Is it actually dead?
Make a heal check.
Okay, what's my heal?
I'd ask Aster to make a heal check, but I don't trust him around it right now.
Aster, you think it's dead.
Snacks,
you also think it's dead.
I carry its body around because it seems suspiciously not dead.
Really? Because you're fairly certain it's dead.
Well, I was fairly certain it was dead a couple minutes ago.
Yeah, but even Snacks is telling you it's dead now.
It's dead.
So, Thrain, you notice key signs of it regenerating itself.
Yeah. This thing seems dead. It seems to be regenerating. I don't know how. I've never seen this before. It must have fast healing or something.
Fast healing can't bring you back from the dead.
Or regeneration, the actual regeneration ability.
Yeah, well, Thrain doesn't know that much.
Okay.
It's like some kind of fast healing type thing. That's what it looks like to him. Stop making fun of this guy. He didn't go to school.
He's a half ogre, right? Or half orc.
Half orc. Yeah.
Ask Thrain. Try and deal enough damage to it so it doesn't regenerate for a while.
Are you going to keep hitting it every round to keep it down?
We'll hit it this round.
We don't even know if this thing is...
take care of it for a while.
So, important question regarding PvP. Am I allowed to try and push Aster back so he stops hitting this thing so we can talk to it?
While he's holding it and beating it to death.
Wait. Aster. Hang on a second, Aster. Let's see what this thing really is. Could be useful.
Fine.
Who had the knowledge check on it earlier, Dominic?
Snacks. Yeah, Snacks did. I know it's lawful evil.
Do you know anything else about it? You seem to be the biggest expert in this, whatever it is.
I throw the ball of knives at Arubis.
You
throw it at me. Knowledge done.
Yes.
Well, I'm not gonna catch it. That'd be foolish.
I'll try and catch it. My max carrying capacity is 30 pounds.
Knife ball.
Just jump to the air and grab it.
A knife ball.
It's a tiny creature, so you might be able to carry it, Gekko.
I try to catch it and not only protect Erebus, but maybe take it away from Master.
Understood.
Do I have to make any kind of save as I touch it?
Nope.
Keep away.
All right. I try to hold on to it with my teeth and kind of move it around carefully, not trying to bite it.
Wants to play knife ball.
I will watch over it for now. If it hurts anybody, it will be on my hands.
All right, let's go.
Okay, so while you've been talking, it's been regenerating and it comes back to life again.
Okay. So, Breck will attempt to diplomatize and ask it.
Is anyone attacking it or taking hostile actions?
No.
Well, let's ask after, actually. After.
Nah.
Cool, man.
Okay. Yeah, are you holding it in your mouth?
No, I had to let it out to speak to it again.
Okay. It immediately, like, bursts away from you guys in a withdrawal action.
Oh, it has damn it.
All right, let's go.
Oh, that way?
Hold on. We don't mean you any harm.
I think it's too late, bro. Too late to apologize.
I think after almost killing
everyone hold where they're at, guys.
Yeah, okay.
What happens if you throw a regenerating creature in lava?
I'm pretty sure that is the end of the regenerating creature.
Well, not necessarily.
It could be immune to fire.
Well, it can't regenerate fast enough, though.
Unless it's immune to fire.
Eventually, in a patch of lava that gives us a sign cooldown, then it comes back to life, stuck in stone forever.
Oh my!
Wow, that sounds wonderful to me.
Okay. So you see a rotten, or I'm sorry, you smell a rotten smell from deep within the earth that fills this wide cavern.
Answer this.
Rumbling through fissures and bubbling up from a river of magma that courses through the cave. A stony formation at the cave center forms a green shoot over the fire fires. So, Ed, sir, when you move there, you see that there is... Let's have everyone stop moving again. Underneath the bridge... There's some sort of whirlwind that's formed entirely of, green gas that's floating down there. It seems to be hiding, and there's two more along the ceiling above you. They're just floating around.
Can I do a knowledge check?
Sure.
Okay. I need to... Adjust my macro, because it is off by one.
So, my name is Gekido.
I'll step up to try to speak to him.
Okay, you're going to spend a minute to talk to them?
I am. I know. Everybody else.
Do you have a knowledge check on what these things are?
Knowledge planes. Mm-hmm.
That was a very specific one.
Time.
Let's see here. Erebus and Snacks, 26 and a...
Well, he's talking...
31.
31.
What are you doing, Kai?
While he's talking, can we move around?
Yes. So you guys basically know everything there is to know about these creatures, between the two of you.
I don't think I've ever seen these creatures before.
You have not seen these specific creatures, but, You're able to intuit their abilities using both of your skills as scientists.
The alchemy to make better food for the next generation of man.
As Answer moves across, do they suddenly become hostile?
No, as you begin talking to them, right before you finish talking to them, immediately, they're just flying around, they're not really paying attention to you while you're talking, and then right before you finish, they leap towards you guys.
Oh... I've been making myself get louder and louder. It's like, hello, I'm over here. Come on, I just want to talk.
Why can't we be friends?
My great grandfather Enjo says always to speak with kindness first, and teeth second.
Sometimes that gives away your position.
It's actually a pretty super creepy thing for threatening to say. He's like hiding in the back behind a rock. He's like, sometimes the rock gives away your position.
You missed
out on
the
sneak attack.
Yeah.
We're missing somebody.
Boom. Chain as usual, sorry. He's running to away position.
You failed me for the last time.
Now,
congratulations, Admiral Pierre. Alright, Gekido, you notice these guys are rearing up to strike.
Yes, I do. God dang it. Okay, you said one's on the ceiling, and then two are on the ceiling, and one's down in the lava.
Yep.
How high is the ceiling?
Obviously, Gekido jump for this is gonna be awesome.
That reflex, that breath weapon is gonna be.
No, I'm gonna be moving in a position where I won't. I don't know. I'm waiting for them to turn into whirlwinds.
Sure, the ceiling's 30 feet high.
30 feet, okay, it's 30 feet high from the platform.
All I'm gonna say is don't fall into.
The bridge is raised 5 feet over the lava, so.
I would survive one round of 20d6 damage.
And this one is located underneath the bridge, not on it.
Okay.
In that case, I will delay my action. Until after them.
Let's see here.
Uh-oh.
That should work.
Lines.
Yeah. The cones are gonna be painful.
You're about to receive the cones of Dunshire!
Cones of Dunshire.
The cones of Dunshire! So this guy's gonna can fly to here. Alright. And then they just begin spraying breath weapons all over all of you. So I need 3 reflex saves from Gek, Breck, the Mount, Battlecat, and Thrain.
Do they just ignore Snacks and Arubis?
Yes.
Apparently,
they all
it's
seem
come
to be focusing on the one who keeps talking to them.
Uh-oh.
Damn.
Wow, look at those rolls.
Now, excuse me. There's no reason to resort to this.
Talking gives your position away.
I like that.
Compared to a giant dinosaur crossing across the way.
How many reflex? One for each?
One for each. So 3 of them.
Well, Train Valcat just died in the first one. Okay, let's see. Some more.
So, what is the difficulty on these?
You gotta be joking.
It is DC.
I just
want
to two.
Okay, so Skirms takes no damage. And Breck will take
all
full on the first set 2 and half on the last.
Okay. I need anyone that takes any amount of damage at all to make a fortitude save every time that they are hit.
What kind of damage is this?
This is poison-type acid damage.
Cool.
Called caustic.
Yay. Poison acid.
My fort save is significantly lower than my reflex save.
Actually, all of you have life bubble up, right? Is there
yes.
anyone that's
yeah.
in the hit here that doesn't have life bubble?
No, answer was the one who didn't have it.
None
sure
of you
yet.
Can be affected by the poison because it's inhaled.
Alright, but we still take the damage.
So no reason to make those fortitudes. Yes, you still take the damage because you're being sprayed with acid.
6,
okay.
7, 13, plus
right.
4, 18.
Thank goodness for life bubble. Go train, go.
You're the man.
as soon as the acid spray goes away.
None
no.
of you took any damage from that, except for Gek.
I did. I
Wait,
I took 19 damage.
Took a shitload. Battlecat took one
17.
Hit change to 2.
You see all these full health bars, and I'm deeply ashamed.
Okay, so 27, and then the last one.
Don't worry, they haven't adjusted their health yet.
I moved myself onto the white of the griffin so that you could see the difference between max and not max. I am still a barbarian, yes. Lots of health.
And Breck took a lot.
He takes, let's see, 27 plus 6, he takes 33.
How high up off the ground are they now?
They're floating above their squares.
So 5 feet in the air?
No, they're just literally floating in the square that they're in.
Oh, okay, so they're on that square.
Yep.
Does Guido not have evasion?
I don't have evasion, I'm a barbarian. 5 foot step.
Wait, don't barbarians get evasion?
No, we get uncanny dodge.
Oh yeah, that's what I'm doing.
I provoke as I step into its square, meaning to do it harm. For it did me and my companions harm.
Okay.
I also begin my rage.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. No, 32. Before, after rage. After my attack, I'll be a 35.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, the reflex save was for half?
Reflex was for half.
Yeah.
Okay, then I've taken a little bit more damage.
I had to unclip my rage for my reflex save, so I forgot to re-include it for my bite attacks, so just 2 higher on the hits and damage.
So, another 2 damage for each hit?
Yes.
So another 6.
Okay. I'm done.
Alright, Aster.
Alrighty. And she's going to move here and...
So wait,
count as
were you
yet?
Just full attacking with your things?
Yes.
Oh, that's a bad thing. Because he burns you every single time.
Indeed.
I'll take it.
Would
stop.
This count as in melee yet?
Just a sec, I have to take all of his burns. So let's
see. I am not very intelligent.
Acid.
Or wise. After the first attack, I'll probably take the second and the third, and then after the third, I'll think about taking more.
So you'll take 3d6 damage, and then you need to roll 3 reflex saves to see if they stick.
Okay, so first attack.
Yep.
10 damage. Next attack. And last attack, I guess, because I'm going to take all of them.
Uh-huh. Alright. The acid burns
you. Oh, 3d6 from one from each?
Yes.
Oh, I was expecting 3d6 from like each attack.
Each one does a d6 of burn.
Okay.
So my understanding of the way burn works is it's automatically added onto the attack as per its description, and then if you fail the save
then you are caught on fire.
Yes.
It's acid burn though, that's cool.
Alright, Aster. What's the question here?
Is this one in melee yet? Because it hasn't struck in melee, I'm just wondering.
It is in melee with battle.
It just has to be next to it.
Yeah.
Alright. Just 1 second. Just checking the stats you gave us.
If you have a way of creating a large wind, that would be really nice.
So it should be noted, Jack, that your attacks did not deal full damage as your magic.
Okay.
I did not prepare wind wall, so no.
Good. I am not good in wind, no.
Well, they all count as tiny too, so it would be terrible for them. But let's hit I'm going to try and hit the one in front of me with Morningstar.
Okay.
Alright.
Like.
And a power bite on the other one.
Okay.
It's not going to continue to grab.
Okay, it couldn't grab anyway.
Yeah. It's just not going to.
Okay, it hits and destroys this creature in the process, but it takes some damage, and I need you to make a reflex save.
Alright.
Takes 2 acid.
And is the other one hit? Oh, wait, yes it is. We know everything about it.
It'd be cool to see a Phantom of the Opera T-Rex wearing like a face mask to cover his acid burns.